And welcome back, folks. Welcome back to Let's Play Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Last time we died for the very first time. So this is, I think, the third level. Which is, the beginning of this level is quite hard. Once you make it through, the beginning of this level, it's not that much more difficult than, the rest of the game. The problem here is that there's just so many enemies. It is difficult, but I don't think that the challenge is unfair. I mean, I hate this little boy. I have to be honest. There's one thing that I really hate, it's this little shithead. Okay, but we made it past, basically made it past this annoying section. Well, basically, meaning that not really. Okay. Okay, so we made it past this part. Now comes a section that is also quite annoying, but for a different reason. So here we are fighting against... Oh yeah, so one problem is that we don't have any coins because we died. And you don't carry over your coins to the next section. That means that we can't actually pay this woman to shut up. So we just have to wait until she stops. Of course, the problem here is that whenever you get hit, you're getting knocked into the direction that you don't want to be knocked back to. And again, so this section, for example, I think is evidence for my theory that the game is intentionally designed to be as annoying as possible. I mean, how could it not be? Okay, so if we can just make it past these shit. So we're almost done with this level. But of course we are only we have two health bars left. And I'm not actually sure whether these bees take away your life meter or not. Shit. Okay. So this will be quite difficult. The only thing that's really a problem are these satellites. If you can... Yeah, and that's... you can usually dodge them. Meaning usually when you are not being attacked by something else and you're not paying attention. If you can, I would advise you to shoot these satellites. Which, however, is also not very easy, so... Just don't get hit. That's... There's one thing that you need to learn. Don't get hit. Okay. Yes, and I know that I keep jumping over this boy, even though this is unnecessary, but... I mean, the thing that you have to keep in mind here, that this is still the easy part of the game. The real challenge will be the barrel stage. So one thing that you, so one strategy that you can adopt when you're being just gang raped by these type 2 enemies and you want to avoid the bomb guy, just walk towards him and force him to drop the bomb. Because generally he doesn't respawn. Sometimes he does. Sometimes he respawns immediately. But often you can just you can just get rid of him this way. I don't know of a good strategy for dealing with this singing lady, except that you need to wait until she stops singing. Yeah, but even then, it's very difficult to avoid these music notes. You can duck can duck in this game, and I think when you do that you can avoid some of the blast of the bombs, but I'm not sure about this, so ah, shit. Okay, but... should be okay, since... So generally, of course of course, generally, want your life meter to be as high as possible, but at least when you go to the hide stage. But from my experience, that if you start with at least half the meter filled, then usually I can complete the stage. Yeah, so try to get your Jekyll meter low. Okay. So yeah, sometimes the bomb will get you no matter what. Maybe I was not far enough away. Sometimes the game is just weird, and okay. Shit. Yeah. It's not... Yeah. So we have to do this again. Unfortunately. But the game isn't... I mean, it's an NES game, so it's... It isn't actually that long. Okay. Even though this stage is not the most difficult stage, I think this is probably my least favorite stage. Yeah, but so the only thing that I can say is, fuck. no, the only thing that I can say, the only useful thing I can say, is, shit. Sorry, I keep being distracted. So the only useful thing I can say is force the purple guy who's laying these bombs, force him to lay his bomb early and hope that he doesn't respawn. Because then you're only dealing with one type of enemy and it's somewhat... Yeah. It's still not fun, but it's not as annoying as when you try to avoid the purple guy and these other guys at the same time. Okay. And this should be sufficient. Okay, now. So, yeah, so right now, just try to get, okay, so now he respawned, but sometimes he doesn't, okay, fuck, and now, so the problem is that, my life meter is already quite low. You can actually use the bomb blasts to lower your jackal meter. It does take away both your life meter and your jackal meter. But there is a way actually to... to control how much life versus jackal meter it takes away. So basically, when the explosion goes off, you want to walk away from it, so that it doesn't take away too much life. But still be close enough so that... Shit, fuck! But still close enough so that it also reduces your height meter. I hate this stage. Well, when we'll come back, folks, we will continue trying to complete that stage, and then there will be the barrel stage next, which I have never actually defeated. So yeah, we will see about that. Until next time, folks, until then.